Hi, Susan here. Okay, today we're gonna start sewing. We're gonna get this top part of the bodice started, and that's what's next. Guys, so I don't want to overwhelm you or myself, so we're going to go piece by piece with this gown, okay? Because there's a ton of pieces and a lot of components to this gown, right? It's a little complicated. I want to make it as simple as possible for you to understand. So I'm referring back to my original scribble. I enjoy my original scribble because I understand the motivation behind my sketch, so I'm just kind of referring to it, but we're going to kind of work here on this top part of the bodice. And so I'm going to show you those pieces. We have the underneath structure here and here, and then we have the gathered lace on top. Remember that gathered lace here on top? So we're just going to kind of work on that upper body. Before I get started, I wanted to reach out to you guys, and I hope you're having a good time with these vlogs. I hope you're enjoying them. I hope you're learning something in each one of them. That is my goal for the vlogs. But I also wanted a little bit more with my vlogs. I wanted to expand it to incorporate the entire fashion industry. So I'm asking you guys a favor. Give me some feedback, please. Give me ideas of who you may want me to interview or what you want me to expose or show from the fashion design industry in the description box below, because I'm working on some interviews. That's in the back end of it, but I would love to have your feedback. So with that said, let's get to this dress, okay? Here on the flat, we have the pieces just for that upper part. Just for this section here on top, believe it or not. So this is the side bodice, side front bodice, the triangle in the front. This is the side back upper bodice. And here they are in the sections. This is going to go underneath to clean it, but this is going to be the ones that we're going to be sewing first. And then this was the gathered, this is the lace that we're going to be gathering, right, around that top bodice. So what I'm going to do is, my dilemma is, do I want to double it here, because this fabric is kind of sheer. So let's see what I'm going to do with that. Okay, I decided to put the interfacing on the top part of the bodice, but I'm using my jersey instead. And this is a jersey interfacing that stretches. I'm using the stretchy part for the top part of the front, and I'm using the non-stretchy part of it for the back side of the top pieces. I'm going to use a damp cloth and adhere this iron, and I'll be right back. So here are the fused pieces that I have here, and I have them laid out properly. Here is the pattern, so you can see this is the center front, this is the side front bodice, these are the back pieces of the bodice. And I'm also going to be doing a French seam because I need a small seam and I don't want to marrow it. So I'm going to have to put wrong sides together first, pin them, stitch them one way, and then encase that seam. I put an easing thread stitch on the curved part of that bust, because that has to fit into this, and this curve has to have a little bit of ease. So then I did that, and I sewed them together at 1/4 inch. Now I'm going to press them like this, trim it, and I'm going to encase the seam, putting right sides together so that that French seam is in there. I wanted to kind of show you on the flat what I did with everything. These are the pattern pieces. I'll move them aside. Here's extra pieces. This is the center. I did both the outside part and then the lining. I actually backed them all with my fusible jersey interfacing. And I put this one together with French seams, and I just lightly put this together with a larger stitch so that I can try it on, which is I'm going to show you next. This is the underlining here as well. I also have that backed with my jersey interfacing that's fusible, and I double backed it here on the back because I want that to hold me together and hold everything up, just like an undergarment or a bra would have, right? So we have those pieces here. This is the lace that we're going to do gather and mold to this on the dress form next week. So let me show you this on, because I do want to always check it on the mannequin and check it me as well to make sure that the fit is working as we go with this project. Okay, let me show you now. So yay, it fits me nicely, woohoo! So it's cupping really nicely, and I have it on the dress form, the underneath part as well, just to show you that it's molding to the dress form beautifully. So thumbs up, we achieved the understructure part and the top part of this bustier, and we're going to get to the lace next week. And I thank you so much for watching. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video. Subscribe if you haven't already. Give me a comment. I want your feedback. I'll see you next week. Thank you. Bye-bye.